Justin, Hollywood Bets Kenilworth on Saturday the 16th of November. Race one, you've got number 14, Elsinore, Gavin Arena aboard. Showing good improvement. Will he enjoy the extra and also the Hollywood Bets Kenilworth straight?
He's definitely looking for further. He shouldn't be running that well over thousands, to be honest, but he does show a little bit of pace at home. I think he'll run a creditable race here. Very strong field. There's a few horses that certainly will give him a go. He'll need to have a bit of luck in running. So maybe a each way chance.
Race two, perfectly placed, maiden plate, 1400 metres, number four ahead of the fact, Robert Carty's aboard.
He's certainly a horse that's going to go a little bit further, so watch him, because next time when I put him over ground, he's certainly a horse that can go into everything.
Number eight, Land of the Rising Sun, Richard Faree, he seems to be on the up.
I gelded him, which is going to make a big difference. This is certainly a horse for the punters to follow when I go the long run in. Crying for the long run in. I was crying for Kenilworth, and as soon as we got here, now I'm crying for the long run in. A horse that will run through the divisions as soon as we get there, but this is his comeback run from gelding. But wouldn't be surprised to see if he were to win. He is a very nice horse for the future.
Akavanga, number 15, unfortunate draw to overcome, but good debut.
If he'd drawn well, I would say he'd probably win. Drawn there, need complete luck, and unfortunately from that draw on this track I will have to drop him out to the back of the field. So punters, watch. If he runs through the field, you know, next time put.
Race three, Race Cape, powered by Hollywood Bets. Progress plate, 1400 meters, number one without question. First run, is this from KZN's prep run?
Yes, I had no luck in the tail, couldn't get him sound. I've got him sound now. One for the punters to watch. Obviously it's going to be short, but certainly one to keep an eye on.
Number three, Snow Pilot, brilliant win last time. Has he tightened up a bit from that?
No. That's why I'm back into the 14. He's still huge. He was big. I can't remember what the exact amount was, but I think he was like 15 kilos overweight last time. Had no right to win. Still heavy, but certainly watch him in his next start. But in saying that, in a progress plate, he is so well in, we would be surprised to see him get beat. I know there's some young horses with a lot of talent, but they'll have to be superstars over this course and distance to beat him.
Number four, Rockpool. Did he need his last run?
Yes, and he definitely did. This is a comeback run. Look and watch over further.
Number eight, Triple Time. JP up, is this serving as a prep run?
Couldn't get him sound in the Natal season. Certainly a prep run, but for punters, keep an eye on this horse. Flying at home. Just don't know which way he's going to go for the Cape season, whether he's actually good enough to run, let's say, in the Met, or he'll be a stayer. Certainly a serious horse over ground.
Race four, the Western Province Nomad Class 3, over 1400 metres. The two runners, with Inamoro being scratched. Number two, Power and the Glory, Richard aboard. Without placing expectations on him, how is he doing? Is he fit? Will he need
the
run?
He's doing very well at the moment. I'm expecting a nice come-on run from him. He's a horse that I think will also be better suited in the long run in, but a horse that he's got it all set up here, but I had to put him away. He got a 95 or 96 after winning a maiden, and to be honest, wasn't the strongest field. So certainly a horse that I've had to just give him as much time, and I don't want to run him at Durnville. Certainly a one for punters to follow.
Number eight, Tuta Faye, JP aboard, the 56 kilos. Could we ignore his last run?
Also draws are always an issue with him. Here he's got half a chance, but there's some very smart individuals in this race. So I think of a horse that you could watch maybe when the race is a little bit weaker. Hopefully things go his way.
And as mentioned, number 14, Inamoro, is scratched. Race five, the Infinity Insurance Cape B Stakes over the 1800 metres. Three runners. Number three, Song to the Moon, Richard aboard. Well fought win last time. Could he follow up?
Yes, he is that type of horse. I'm trying the 1800, but he is a horse that certainly could win a few more races. So expect a nice run from him.
Number four, Magic Verse, JP up. You tried him over this trip last time. Is he looking for the extra?
I don't know. We're going to see. He's lost in translation. He won two races, looked impressive, gone backwards. I'm trying this. But a horse that just don't leave him out of anything. He has got some ability.
Number six, Give Me More Time, Craig Zaki aboard. He's got exposed form, but hints that he's honest and consistent, prefers this trip.
Right horse, right jockey. I think he'll ride him well. He's always gives of his best, but tough field.
Race six, Bright Insurance Cape Sea Stakes, 1950. three runners, Greenland. Does he prefer Hollywood Bets Kenilworth?
And the long running. Him and Quite a King will be more effective when they hit the long running. Certainly horses that can pop up here, don't leave them out of anything. They are those type of horses.
You also have number five, Groove Jet, JP aboard. An easier draw should help him. He runs on very well.
Very much so, but also another one. When the long run comes in, he'll be a serious contender. But very hard to oppose on his current form.
Race 7, the Grade 3 Cape Mile, obviously 1600 metres. The three runners, first in Tlahlui with JP up. He looks to be well suited to the mile and a big galloper.
Yeah, very much so. I didn't have much joy with him. I thought his runs that he ran in the Natal season were very good. I mean, to go the 2-2, didn't have much luck in the Hollywood Durban July. And he still, I think, only got beat by four lengths. I've worked really hard with this horse off season. I've put a lot of effort into him. I do think he'll be better in the long straight, but he's a horse I'm expecting some improvement and maybe something to showcase that he's a horse to follow in the season. So he's going to be a very interesting runner on Saturday, certainly one that I'll be watching.
Number eight, it's Rainy William, Cornet up. He's got the pace, which seems to be an asset. Will he need the run?
Yeah, because he goes so hard. So I'm using this as a gallop. He'll go 100 miles an hour in front and he'll be ready for his next start. But he's a tough bugger. I gave him a double sprint up this morning and he had no brakes. So he loves it, loves it. It's the way he likes to race. You know, let's see how he goes. But there's some big hitters here that normally he's not up to that sort of level, but some of them need a run. So let's see how it goes.
The last of your runners, number nine, Royal Aussie, Richard Faria aboard. He runs well fresh. Is this his goal? What is his goal for the season?
No, certainly. Look, with a lot of horses retiring, he's probably one of the better milers in the country, make no mistake. He had no luck in the Natal season. He sadly picked up a virus, but probably one of the worst viruses I've seen. So I had no season with him. He missed everything, the Gold Challenge. And then I had to bring him back in a 1200 in a Group 1, He almost won it. So a horse you really got to respect. It is his first run back, but doing well at home and you can expect a nice run from him.
Race 9, the CRS Cape Summer Sale. Class 4, fillies and mares, two runners. First then Protect the Dream. Down in trip, will she find it a bit sharp?
It's a hard one. If there's horses that you fancy more in this race, then probably go with those. But it is a filly that I think The Kenilworth 1200 is a tough 1200, so I think it's in a range, probably better over 14, but certainly a filly that may be a small chance, but quite a tough field this.
Talking about a tough field, number three, I'm So Pretty, she's had two convincing wins. Could she consider one to follow? Is this the test to then determine that?
Yeah, I would say so. She's really well at home. She's going through the divisions. Obviously, there's a lot of talk about Babelicious, and you know, I always hear those rumors from Milnerton. There's actually a lot of rumours that come from Milnerton, but this is one of them that she can run a bit, so you always respect that. But this filly's doing well at home and you could expect, I think, another big run from her.
Race 10, Hollywood Bets Bright Future Maiden Plate for the fillies and mares, 1200 metres. Number 4, Beach Queen, well related, and a debut she could improve on?
Yes, certainly yes she can. Maybe for the small each way chance, throw in another big field, competitive bunch, so it's not going to be easy, but certainly a filly. I wouldn't say she's shooting lights out at home, but her work's okay.
Number 11, Wild Applause, Richard Faria aboard. She's got the pace. Did she do a little bit too much up front over the 14 last time?
Very much so, and funny enough you say that. This morning in the sprint up I thought she did the same, so I'm a little bit worried. It was a winning sprint up. But you know when a sprint up's too good, I think she overexerted herself. I saw this filly coming down 100 miles an hour and it does concern me a little bit to Saturday. So I'm going to keep a good eye. We've got a vet check this afternoon. If she clears that, then certainly a filly that you've got to earmark. She's going to win her races. She's well related. But as I said, if there's anything I'm not too confident about, I will certainly take her out.
Thank you, Justin. All the best.
Great. Thank you very much.